In this video, we will talk about the power produced by a wind turbine. How does it vary with the wind speed? And what about the rotation speed of the rotor? After watching this video, you will be able to explain the different operational regimes of a wind turbine, to quantify the dependency of the power produced with the wind speed, and also to define and explain the notion of capacity factor. In a previous video, we saw that the power extracted by the wind turbine equals the force exerted by the flow on the rotor times the flow velocity at the rotor. An important concept in fluid mechanics is the notion of conservation laws. In particular, mass is conserved when the fluid moves along the stream tube shown by the green dashed line. It can be shown that this implies that the force exerted by the rotor equals the mass flow rate m dot times the velocity at the rotor. Since the mass flow rate is itself a function of the velocity, t is a function of the velocity squared. And by inserting this result in the definition of the power, it follows that p is a function of the cube of the velocity. This is an important result to keep in mind. Thus, across a wide range of wind speeds, the power produced by a wind turbine varies with the cube of the wind speed. This is shown on this plot, which illustrates the power as a function of the wind speed. This, however, holds only for a certain range of wind speeds. Indeed, at very small speeds, there is not enough wind for the turbine to actually rotate. The wind speed at which the rotor starts to rotate is called the cutting speed. Below this value, no power is produced. The cutting speed is typically about 3 to 4 meters per second. On the other hand, if the wind is very strong, the loads on the rotor can become too large. Therefore, the so-called cut-out speed is the maximum wind speed at which power can be safely produced. This lies typically around 25 meters per second. Finally, the electrical generator also imposes a limit on the power that can be output. Just beyond a certain wind speed, the power is limited to a constant value. This value is called the rated power and typically occurs for wind speeds between 12 and 17 meters per second. In this context, wind turbine control has two main purposes. In normal conditions, it makes sure that the power does not exceed the rated power. And in off-design conditions, it brings the system to a safe state, for example, during extreme wind gusts. Of course, safety systems should always be able to overhaul the nominal controller. In a previous video, we also saw that for each wind speed, there is an optimum rotation speed for which the power is maximum. Thus, if we plot the power extracted by the wind speed as a function of the rotational speed, it will look like this. Of course, the exact values on this power curve change with the wind speed. The larger the wind speed, the more the extracted power. For each wind speed, control in normal conditions aims at changing the rotational speed of the rotor to achieve the maximum power. Below rated power, this is done through the generator torque and is therefore called torque control. Eventually, when rated power is attained, the power is kept constant by turning the blades along the axis, that is, by pitching them. If my arm is the blade, a pitch rotation is this motion. This is called pitch control and is performed at constant torque. Before concluding this video, I would like to talk about an important concept used in energy production, the capacity factor. The capacity factor indicates the percentage of time a system runs at full power over a reference period of time. In this formula, the actual is the reference time to achieve the given production. For example, 1 year if we're considering the yearly production. The equivalent, on the other hand, is the time needed to achieve the same yearly production if the wind turbine was running all the time at full power. By definition, the equivalent is always smaller than the actual, so that the capacity factor is always smaller than unity. As a consequence, in the ideal case of a wind turbine running all year at full power, without interruption, the capacity factor equals 1. By contrast, if the same wind turbine does not run at all during the year, the capacity factor is 0. Thus, crucially, the capacity factor is not a measure of the quality of the system. Because no matter how good a wind turbine is, if it's always switched off, its capacity factor is 0. This slide shows how a given wind turbine of a given quality can have different capacity factors depending on where it is installed. In particular, the capacity factor of a given wind turbine generally increases with the wind speed. This is also why the capacity factor is usually greater offshore than onshore. As indicated on this slide, offshore, the capacity factor CF is around 0.45. But it should be borne in mind that a very large capacity factor is not necessarily the economic optimum. For example, in a given wind, a smaller wind turbine might have a larger capacity factor than a large wind turbine, but eventually produce less power. This is illustrated by this slide. Imagine that the wind speed varies between 10 meters per second and 20 meters per second at a given location. Placing, let's say, a 1 megawatt turbine at this location might mean that it will run all the time at rated power, thus producing 1 megawatt all year long. By contrast, a 6 megawatt turbine might not be running at rated power all the time, thus its capacity factor will be lower than 1. However, when it does run at full power, it will produce 6 megawatt. So despite its lower capacity factor, the overall power produced by the 6 megawatt turbine might well be larger than that of the 1 megawatt turbine. In this video, we explain how the power produced varies with the wind speed in the different operational conditions. And we also explained the notion of capacity factor and its interpretation for wind power production. In the next video, we will learn how to compute the overall energy produced by a wind turbine.